Hi, people. It's Not the Cool Mom here. Okay, third time's a charm. Trying to bring you a quick video, and it's not working out, so we'll see how this goes. My topic today is foundation, and when I refer to foundation, I refer to women's undergarments. Brassieres, underwear, hosiery, slips, some type of shaping garment, things of that such. So I'll start with pantyhose. So I don't know why, but we're very anti-pantyhose nowadays. Everyone wants to show off smooth legs and things of that such. And kind of, I could think part of it is we're getting away from that in the corporate environment in some aspects, not every aspect. But a lot of businesses are leaning towards business casual versus a business look. So, not wearing any type of hosiery is acceptable. I enjoy not wearing them, but then I also have moments where I definitely recommend them. If you're someone like me that gets cold very easy, it's another layer that you can add to help you out. If you sit or stand a lot, sometimes having that compression actually helps you, will help prevent things, you know, like varicose veins and kind of keep everything in place. It also adds a certain level of sophistication depending on the outfit that you're wearing. So, you know, let's not be anti-hosiery. Whenever it's appropriate, whenever you feel like it, wear them. I will definitely say try to make sure you are choosing the correct size. If you go to places where they have like the eggs and the boxes on the back, they have coordinates that are based on your height and weight. Find your correct size. Understand the difference between, you know, sheer versus a tight versus control top, things of that such. Find something that works for you. The next level, I'm going to kind of go up the body, I will say, is your undergarments. Yes, you need different styles of undergarments. There's no need to have all thongs, all briefs, all boy shorts. Depending on what you wear, it does make a difference, the type of underwear that you have on. Sometimes you don't want people to see your panty line, so you need to choose something that does not show that. And I do recommend wearing underwear. I know some people go commando and all that. I'm not for that. Put on some draws. But anyways, seamless may be necessary depending on the type of pants or dress you have, how tight it fits to your body. The size of them, meaning where it falls on your waist or below the waist and things like that. One thing that I cannot stand is whenever you see a woman bending over and you can see all her business back there, be mindful of that with what you wear. Invest in things that cover that area up. Long tanks, belts that hold the pants to you, things like that. But yes, everything does not need to be lacy, sexy, all of that. Sometimes you just need practical underwear. I do recommend cotton. Sometimes you need that for hygiene and health. If you have any questions, leave them. We'll go over it. The next item that I'll refer to is a slip. So another pet peeve of mine is, especially now, it's getting warmer across the country. Women go out, they have dresses, they have skirts. They are thinner than maybe they realized, or you would expect. If you've noticed in apparel, a lot of the fabrics are getting thinner. Whenever you go outside, the sun hits you without a slip, a lot of times we can see everything. We can see straight through your legs. Sometimes we can see what undergarments you have on, whether it's lacy or briefs and all of that. I don't need to see that. Invest in a slip. Doesn't have to be a full slip, but I would have one of those on hand, at least one. Half slips work also. It is getting harder, at least in my opinion, to find those. You don't just walk into stores and see a rack full of slips anymore. You have to kind of search them out. But if you, you can find them at Target. I know that. I'm sure they have them at things like Walmart, and then you go into department stores, and some have them, some don't. But I would invest in at least one long, full, you know, top to, you know, mid-thigh at least, or to the knee slip, and then a half slip. The next item I would say would be some type of shaping garment. Girdle, if you don't want to call it a girdle anymore. Slimmer, what's the brand? Spanx, things like that. So invest in a good quality one. Understand that just because it costs a lot doesn't mean it's the best. Just because it's inexpensive doesn't mean that it's going to do what the other does also, if that makes sense. You'll have to try it out for yourself to see what works for you. You should be able to breathe. Now, I understand that you want to smooth out and suck in areas that may not naturally be smooth and flat, but you should not be short of breath when wearing these items. So be cautious when choosing your size. The last item that I will refer to is the brassiere. So for whatever reason, we as women, we're always wearing the wrong size brassiere. My recommendation is get a fitting. Go somewhere, department store, specialty store, wherever, where someone can fit you and give you your size. But understand, whenever you get that size, one, that does not mean that every bra in that size will fit you or will fit you properly. Think of it as the same thing as buying a pair of pants. Just because you're a size 4, if you pick up a size 4, any brand out there, they're all not going to fit you the same. Some are not going to fit you, and a lot are not going to fit you properly. So you need to try on a good variety of bras. Once you find the style that you like, I mean, I definitely would say, don't just go in there and grab a bra, say, this is my size, and buy it. It probably won't fit you. You need to try it on before you purchase it. Once you find the bra that you like, that's comfortable, gives you support, mind you, support doesn't mean that they have to shove them together and lift them up for the world to see. But proper support in the position that opposite of where gravity wants them to go. Then whenever you have it, make sure you take good care of it. I recommend hand washing and letting them hang dry. You can, for most of them, put them in the washing machine. I mean, it's, you know, considered washer safe, but a lot of times when you do that, they will lose their shape. A lot of times if they have an underwire, after many wears and tears, that underwire will start to come loose. There's nothing worse than losing your underwire when you're out in public. Somebody's there with me. But understand that things may happen. Your body may change. Like I said, I've gone through a lot of changes in my body. After a while, you need to get refitted. Understand that it's kind of like with clothes. Just because I was a size 4 at one point in my life doesn't mean I'm always going to be a size 4 type thing. You can add that reference to any size that you are, but understand that there may be changes. You may have to be refitted. Every time you would purchase a bra, I would think you would go somewhere that would give you a fitting, my opinion. It may be more expensive, and a lot of times it is going to be more expensive, but it's an investment, because if you have the proper foundation, and I'm talking head to toe, if you have the proper foundation underneath your clothes, you are going to look good in your clothes. If they fit properly also, that's a whole other video. But the confidence you will have whenever things look the way you want them to look. And I'm not saying that you are changing your body or doing anything of that such. I'm saying taking what you have and accentuating it. Just like with makeup, if you want to highlight your eyes, you highlight your eyes. If you want to highlight your lips, you highlight your lips. You know, this is what we do as women. But make sure that you're taking the time to at least think about your foundation and how that makes you look. You'll be amazed once you get the proper items, how your clothes will highlight the benefits of your body. Whether that's only for you to know and you to see, or whether, you know, you're married and your husband likes the way you look in it also, that's great. But, yeah. Think about foundation. Let me know your thoughts. Recommend places in which you can get these items. I would love to know, because even in my area, there's some things that are hard to find. Let's help one another out so we can look good, feel good, be confident, and not embarrass ourselves. Have a great day. Bye.